High unemployment and miseducation led to high crime and drug abuse in the African American community. Inner city residents, as well as the government, realized that putting impoverished people in housing projects was an utter failure. That concentration of joblessness, crime, and generational poverty led to soaring drug abuse rates. The emergence of crack cocaine in the African American community sent an already unstable population plunging further into the abyss. Crack cocaine was a cheap, highly addictive drug that many African American urbanites took to escape the hopelessness that they faced daily. Mothers who were addicted to crack cocaine neglected their children. Crack addicted fathers stole from their children to feed their addiction. Crack destroyed the African American family, and sadly, the community was flooded with it. The demand for crack lured young black men with no visible prospects into drug dealing. Oftentimes, these young men saw no other option outside of selling drugs to take care of themselves and their families. The battle for drug territory led to the proliferation of gangs like the Bloods and the Crips. Death and decay was the backdrop of the 1980s. Out of the chaos of the crack era emerged a subculture of African American youth who used poetic rhyming to talk about the realities of their lives. This rhyming, known as rap or hip-hop, gave the youth an outlet to express themselves. The hip-hop scene exploded in the 1980s. Out of the music evolved a hip-hop culture with its own language and dress code. Hip-hop not only shed a light on the inner city, it also called out the racism that forced black people into such dismal conditions.
I sit alone in my four-cornered room, staring at candles.
Who got me?
Real radio, Duke. Yeah. Oh, all right.
The chaos of the 90s were a result of the broken families and neglected youth of the crack era. The biggest threat to African American males was no longer the Ku Klux Klan, but it was other black males. The murder statistics in the African American community were staggering. One out of every 21 black males would be murdered before the age of 25. Most would die at the hands of another black male. The glorification of gang culture led to the senseless murder of thousands of African American males. Just as the rappers of the 80s spoke out about the ills of living in the hood, filmmakers of the 90s peeled back the layers, exposing the factors that created the gang culture and the end result of embracing that culture. These coming-of-age tales were cautionary lessons to young black men. On the evening of March 3rd, 1991, Rodney King was drugged out of his car, tasered, handcuffed, and beaten by four white police officers. King was struck 56 times and suffered multiple fractures. The event was captured on tape, and the officers were indicted and stood trial on April 29, 1992. Each officer was found not guilty. African Americans took to the streets in protest of the unjust verdict. Within hours, South Central was engulfed in flames. Protesters confronted police officers, looted and set fire to non-black businesses, and attacked whites who were near the melee. The Bloods and Crips forged a truce to focus their efforts on fighting against police brutality. The LA riots lasted for 6 days and resulted in 2,000 injuries and cost $800 million in damages. 55 people lost their lives during the riots. The unjust Rodney King verdict proved to black America that they couldn't receive justice in America. Therefore, African Americans turned away from mainstream society and celebrated their blackness. African Americans proudly displayed their culture in every genre of art. In the 1990s, African Americans dominated the TV airwaves with positive portrayals of middle-class black life. Black designers developed clothing that was specifically designed and marketed to black people. Cross Color and Carl Kana show that the black community supported their own. Many African Americans set records and top charts in the 90s. Michael Jordan revolutionized the game of basketball with his signature Air Jordan dunking styles. Will Smith broke barriers when rap won its first Grammy. Mariah Carey broke the record for most consecutive number one hits on the Billboard charts. Toni Morrison was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature. Oprah Winfrey became the first African-American female to have a nationally syndicated talk show. Franklin Rames, was the first black CEO of a Fortune 500 company. Rap mogul Russell Simmons launched Fat Farm, a versatile clothing company with both urban and business casual styles. For the first time in history, Cal Gist was crowned Miss USA. Dr. Mae Jemison was the first African-American female astronaut in space. Despite its rough beginnings, African-Americans ended the 90s on a cultural upswing.